What we're going to do right now is we have baptism certificates and gifts that we would like to present to these three young ladies here. Back in June, they were baptized, and I haven't had the opportunity to give them their certificates or their gifts. Also, this is a time that we bring them into the church. Is that right, Judy? I'd like to skip first and second and just do everything right now. Can we do that? Okay, I got the nod. Okay, good. So, Brianna, you can hold this. Here is your baptismal certificate. And what I want you to do is keep this someplace where you always know where it is, but don't just leave it there. Inside here is all the things that you studied and all the things that you said you believed in when you gave your heart to Jesus Christ. Okay? So every once in a while, I want you to take this out. Okay? But more than that, I want you to keep your eyes and your focus on Christ. Because you can know all of this and you can memorize all of this, but if Jesus isn't in your heart, this means nothing. Understand that? As you continue to grow, have a friendship with Him like you might. Can you guys hear me? Am I speaking loud enough? Because I can't, I only got 2 minutes. This is going to fall. So, it's been my pleasure and my honor to give you this big old box. And your baptism certificate. Thank you for that too. There you go. Okay, stand with the first time.
Amen. Amen.
Mari, it's your turn. Same thing I said to her. Do you know what's actually inside here? You ever see one of these? Okay. Has your name, the date you were baptized, the officiator, and the church clerk. So you are official. But in here has everything that the church believes and that you went over and you were taught before your baptism. But as I told Brianna, none of this means anything if you do not have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. So today you've got to bring the Bible, right? You're going to use it? Why? Like it. Fantastic. The Bible she got is a big one, and it has all of the comments from Ellen White. Also has a concordance and a Bible dictionary. If you take the Bible and you actually use it and keep it for the rest of your life, keep Jesus close to your heart, no matter what happens to you, no matter where you go, how life turns out, you'll always be in the right place. Understand? You ready for your big box? You guys know what's inside this big box?
Yes,
Ellen White. No, it's a surprise. I'm just waiting for you. Esme, this is yours as well. And what I said to them, I'll say to you. But take this, open it up and look at it yourself. Okay? Everything in there, you said you agree with, right? Okay? I'm going to say this to all of you gathered here. You could memorize the Bible from Genesis to Revelation. If you don't know the God of that Bible, and if you don't have a relationship with Jesus Christ that is portrayed in that word, that book means nothing. There's no magic in that book. What that book tells us is that there's a God that you serve. There's a God that loves you with all of His heart. There's a God that was willing to give His Son so that you could be saved. When you take a verse like John 3:16 where it says, "For God so loved the world," instead of using the word "world," put your name in there. For God so loved Esme, Mari, and Brianna that He gave His only begotten Son that you would not have to perish. But that if, you know what that word "if" means? It's choice. And every day you need to make a choice. Okay? And every day you wake up, choose Jesus Christ. You do that, no matter what happens going ahead, you go to bed at night, you get to sleep well. How many of you ever suffer from insomnia? Before you became a Christian, how many of you suffered from insomnia? Okay, I sleep really good at night because I have Christ in my heart. Okay? So, with that, I'd like to present you with this gift. Lester, can you come back here? Ricky, can I get you? Ben, can you come up here as well? Chuck, can you come up here too? Father, have prayer. I would like to start. I'd like to ask Ricky to go next. Dan, do the heaven, the close, for the prayer. All right. Come on, gather around these girls. Heavenly Father, I ask for your special blessing and protection upon each of these young ladies here. Father, they have a special place in my heart, and I know how special they are to you. So, Father, I ask that you be with them, that as they continue to grow and mature, that they will not lose the faith that brought them to the decision of accepting Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Father, they've been baptized. They're a part of your last day remnant church. Father, I pray that you will touch them and fill them with your Holy Spirit, that you will use them in a mighty way to be witnesses for you, that they will reflect the character of Jesus Christ in all that they do. For this I ask and pray in Jesus' name.
Father, I thank you for these young ladies. I pray that you would reach your mighty hand down and give them a loving touch, that they would always want to follow you and seek your face. I pray that you would give them that peace that surpasses all understanding, and may they each have a hunger and thirst for you and for your word, for your righteousness and for your presence, that would guide them through their life and into heaven. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Lord, I see three beautiful young ladies. We'd like to ask that you would put your protecting hand over them, that you would fill their lives with your Holy Spirit, that you would give them the strength to stay pure for you. We think of three young men somewhere in this world. And one day we'll probably be looking for a wife. And we ask that you would look at those young men and keep them pure for these girls, so that they can have three families that are solid for you.
Amen.
For your kingdom, that they can be circles of their churches and their communities. I thank you for these girls, Lord. Bless them mightily. We ask in Jesus' name.